Welcome to Planet Ayurveda, and today we are going to understand about a very interesting way how we can understand the proper, like how we can differentiate between people of Vata, Pitta and Kapha. And it is a very easy way in Ayurveda that we can make friends, how to choose our friends. So normally in a charka they have given that you can make your enemies and friends according to their body type also, how their mind is, how stable they are with you. So here in my clinic today is the Vata person sitting there in white shirt, and there this is Pitta again in red, and here she is purely Kapha. And how we can differentiate is, see, the Vata person, the main property is the person is very lean. And normally whatever they eat, they digest it fast.
The digestion system is very fast.
Yeah.
Whatever he eats, he digests it fast. Moreover, he's lean, his hairs are sometimes thin hairs he's having.
Yeah.
And he's very, you know, energetic. Maybe he's very active, talkative. So that is the property of Vata.
And moreover, Vata people, they are not stable. They keep fluctuating with their thoughts. One time they are doing this thing, other time after just like 5 minutes they want to do something else. And after 10 minutes again they have new ideas. So they are fluctuating with their ideas and they are not very stable on one task. But they are able to do things like 2-3 things together
multiple.
Because of that multiple tasking, because of their property of Vata, because it's always moving.
Yeah.
But Vata patients, they have problems like drying of hair, drying of skin. Sometimes they have scaly skin, particularly in winters. I would suggest that maybe he can give his inputs himself.
Yeah.
Do you agree with that?
I surely do.
Yes, good.
And actually, he's very creative too. Means his imagination powers, like I'm just in the planet Ayurveda also. His teamwork, like he's having very good imagination. He always start exploring things and all. And moreover, like Pitta Prakriti also. This is second one is Pitta Prakriti, and distinguishing between the colors also, like that person is like sometimes darkish, the Vata Prakriti, and Pitta is something pinkish to darkish.
Pinkish and reddish, and when they are more angry, their face becomes
more red.
Yeah, it is different from if the Vata person is angry, his face will not turn that red.
Mm-hmm.
But Pitta, we can make out that how angry the person is, how the blood pressure is going up, and like what kind of hot thoughts or like hatred thoughts that are coming. So Pitta, they are, but it is not the negative trait. They are more energetic also, and the Pitta person, they are more into doing things, more creative, and more aggressive in getting things done. They reach the targets fast. Like once the task is given, they make sure that it is done. It is not, they don't leave it in between like the Vata, because Vata is fluctuating all the time.
Yeah.
But Pitta, they make sure they are more target oriented. And coming to their body type, they obviously have more of sweaty glands, oily glands. Because of Pitta, they excrete out more of water from their body because of the heat. And they also have problems with hair. Because more of heat in the body, it's more like
more hair fall is
normally
there.
We see that Pitta person, they have more hair loss problems because too much of heat, they disturb the hormones, and so the hair fall is like, you can understand any desert area, nothing grows there. So more the heat in the body, it's very difficult to grow something on that hot.
Okay.
Yeah.
So it's very good explanation.
We need to calm down that excess of Pitta in the body to grow something, to sprout out the new roots.
Yeah, okay.
So, and Pitta, they have skin problems, like you can see with her, she has some pimples.
Pimples.
So it is obviously, normally all the Pitta people, they have problems with eruptions sometime or the other in all age groups.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe once they reach 45 plus, still they have some kind of eruptions. Because skin is definitely the affected, it is Bhrajak Pith, and when there is more Pitta, Bhrajak Pith is definitely affected.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And
if she wants to give her own inputs for her Pitta personality, sometimes she lose temper and sometimes she's up and sometimes she's very low.
Very emotional, the Pitta person is very emotional also.
Yes.
Yeah.
Most of the time she's saying aggression.
And Pitta person, they also have digestive issues.
Yeah.
Yeah, they sometimes have loose stomach or mainly Pitta people, they have problems like IBS. Because of their hot thoughts coming randomly all the time, so that affects your digestion. And so you have irregular bowels. So that is very common with Pitta people. Mm-hmm. Now coming to Kapha, she's very beautiful.
My fairy skin and all.
They are more calm, more slow. If you talk about good things, they are calm, they are beautiful, they are pleasant, more comfortable. But if you come to the negative aspect, sometimes they are very slow. But they are very stable with thoughts.
Yeah.
Like they do whatever they do at their own pace. But it is surely done
in a calm way.
Yeah, in a calm way. And coming to the body type of Kapha, they have more problems related to mucus, like too much of respiratory disorder in their young age. But coming to middle age people, the mucus can be in any form. Like even in their, they have problem with joints.
I have.
Because there is deposition of amarasa.
Yeah.
That is the toxic endotoxin. It is the negative part of Kapha that it gets deposited in joints, and they have problem with movements because by nature they are slow. But if there is a toxic accumulation of ama with Kapha, so they have more problems. And there are so many remedies that we can work out, but Kapha, normally they are healthy people. But they have problems regarding mucus, maybe in the upper part or in their joints.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, how can we use these? Now, if we know that we are Vata, Pitta or Kapha type, what would be your recommendation for them on a daily basis, like according to lifestyle, meal or even herbs that they might take, so they will be in good condition? What would you recommend for Vata, for Pitta and for Kapha?
For the Vata Prakriti, like we are having, if they are having digestive issues, like they are having bloating and constipation, we are recommending Sanjeevani. Sanjeevani, what we are recommending, that is one of the Vata pacifier. So if the Vata is in balance, that we can Sanjeevani. And for the Pitta people, we are recommending that Pitta balance to calm down the Pitta. And for Kapha people, we are the detoxifiers we are giving. That how we can detox the body, like ama is accumulated in the body, so there is in planet Ayurveda also we are having amantata chura, that is for to cure the ama.
Normally if we don't go by any medications, like my colleague has told about the medications we use when the person is really sick, like Vata person is really sick or the Pitta is really sick. But in general, in Ayurveda it has been told that how to maintain your body type in a better way. For Vata, we should go for like intake of proper oil, because it lubricates the system. It will lubricate your gut, so that you don't have problems with your constipation or digestive issues and even accumulation of toxins. So taking of regular oil, maybe mustard oil or any edible oil, even olive oil is good. Almond oil is good in small quantity.
So internal use.
Everyday use for Vata is very good. Even the body massage for Vata patient with oil is very effective. And for Pitta, it has been recommended that they should be taking cow ghee, because cow ghee is sheetal, cooling, and it balances the Pitta personality. Because Pitta, they have disturbed hormonal system, and ghee is one thing, it is rich in antioxidants and as well as vitamin E. So it balances all kind of imbalance of hormones, maybe it is thyroid, maybe it is pituitary hormones. So cow ghee is recommended for Pitta. And if they have digestive issues, then we suggest them taking some simple remedies, like taking more of coconut water. Or maybe some light juices like pomegranate juice, cranberry juice. These are recommended for Pitta people because they are cooling in nature and they balance their system. And coming to Kapha, according to Ayurveda, if we typically go for the drug of choice, it is honey. For Kapha people, it has been recommended they drink honey, like maybe 1 spoon daily, and they take hot water regularly. and it balances their complete system.
Okay.
Like they don't have accumulation of mucus in their body, they don't have pains, they don't have any kind of weight gain, because normally kapha is, they have slow metabolism and so they put on weight.
Okay.
So combination of hot water and honey is miracle for kapha people.
Okay, thank you. And what is definitely not good for them out of the meals? What they should not be really eating because it's not doing well? No, it's not doing any good for them. So what they should avoid?
Okay, for Vata, normally it has been said all over the world people are crazy for nuts. That they take almonds, they take raisins, but dry fruit is contraindicated for Vata people because it aggravates their Vata.
Could you tell us now more about what is not really good for them, what they should not eat and what they should avoid really if they are Vata Pitta Kapha type?
See, all over the world they say that dry fruits are good. It is good for everyone, but particularly for Vata people. In Ayurveda, we don't recommend dry fruits because they are very drying in nature and they can aggravate the Vata if taken like. If you are taking a bunch of almonds and a bunch of walnuts all together. But if you take them in a in another form, like you soak them and
in water.
Yeah, in water.
Overnight we soak them and then take
them. Then they absorb moisture and then in that form it is okay for them.
Okay.
Similarly, if too much of spicy food, too much of fried food for pitta person, it aggravates their pitta.
And for dairy products also aggravates the pitta.
Yeah.
We are recommending that milk and egg products like that also aggravate the pitta. So we are not recommending dairy products and maybe spicy food, we are asking to avoid it.
And for kapha, normally we contraindicate taking too much of milk, cheese and yogurts and kind of citrus, too much of lemon and sour fruits, they aggravate kapha. For kapha, normally we recommend that they should avoid all dairy products, milk, cheese and cottage cheese, Indian cheese, and she should not be taking any sour fruits like lemons and oranges. It's not good for kapha patients because it it generates more of mucus in their body because of the ama dosha and slow metabolism. So they should avoid all, and also they should avoid all cold things like ice creams and yogurts and frozen food. It's contraindicated for kapha patients.
I see. Okay. So what can we do if our dosha is already aggravated? If it's too high, how can we help ourselves? What herbs, for example, would you recommend for Vata, for Pitta?
See, in our planet Ayurveda, we have very good combinations for all body types. Like in Vata, Michael, you will explain.
Yeah, in Vata, we can give Ashwagandha.
Okay.
Ashwagandha capsules are there that we are recommending for one in the morning and one in the evening. And the Shtabi we are having. And moreover, we are having Goswila Karkyum. So these are the for the Vata Prakriti. If the person is having Pitta Dosha, like for she is having pimples and all, for that we are having Manjishta capsule. It detoxifies the body and moreover it just heal that pimples and all. And for that Kapha Prakriti, we are having Vasaka capsules, we are having Tulsi. So Tulsi capsule we are giving one in the morning, one in the evening, and we are having
In Pitta, we also have Pitta Balance. We have Manjishta and we have Amlaki Rasayan. Amlaki is a miracle for the Pitta patients because it is cooling in nature and it balances the aggravation of Pitta. And for Kapha, because they have more of mucus deposition in the body, so Vasaka is amazing. Vasaka
is amazing.
Tulsi and Google, because it is little hot in nature, so it melts down the toxic kapha accumulation in the body.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Okay.